Okay, okay. Part two. In previous episodes, you would have noticed this. So this is where we got yesterday. this is basically 3 hours in, I think it was. I didn't get a chance to look for the background graphics. So I'll have to do that tomorrow. We'll concentrate today, I think, on maybe assigning some skills and doing some of the panel work. Yes. I did think about how to do some of the metal stuff as well. And yeah, I think the easiest thing to do is to have a separate bitmap with just the metal sections in it. That's probably the simplest part at the moment. And then I can have a different byte array that's got all the metal stuff in it as well, a buffer. That should be fine. So let's so I think what to do first. I'm tempted to basically do the panel part, and then do selection on the panel, I think. I'm not sure the best way to do that is, so because I'm working in the free version, I am kind of limited, obviously, to what everybody else is. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So I think you get about 20 sprites in the limited beta, and about 10 objects or 15 objects or something. So what I'll do first is, yeah, that sounds like a good idea. Let's create panel in there. Set the cursor in there as well. And that one, and then we'll do that. So what we're going to do is basically chop up the panel, these segments, into frames of a sprite. Okay, so each of these is 16 by 24. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12. Okay. Okay. Now we will also have to change the numbers in it. So for now, we will blank out the numbers. Like that. And let's edit that room. much yet. So, just get my bearings. So, only used three objects so far. So, oh, I know. Frames. Okay. 3, 4, 6, 8, 12. Okay. Now what we can do is in the creation code. If we just set the frame. I think we had something to allow you to set which frame you were on, but apparently not. The starting frame. That might have been assets. So that we might. That's a little bit on this. Nothing, 1, 2, 3, oh, hang on. Oh, I've done it wrong already. 0. So just that one. Okay. And then that one's 3. 4. Do it again. Can I count? Nothing. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes, I don't actually need to do that, do I? What I can do, which is much easier. How wide are these? 16. Okay. So let's index equals x 4. Basically, the x going across is the frame number. So I can just work that out straight away. And stop it animating. Hey presto. I can just ignore the creation code from the other ones. Fine. Much easier. Although I'm only getting the one. That's in the wrong place. Is odd. Moving up to the up here in the GUI. Okay, I'm going to get one because I've renamed that. Just one table. Okay, I'm not sure why I'm not getting any of those. Okay, curiosity. Let's not do anything to it, and it should at least animate and do something. Nothing. So let's disable the draw event. And then inside the draw GUI, because that's where you want to draw the HUD anyway. Okay. There we go. Okay, so now in the create event we can try and pick our panel. There we go. Hey presto. And then now we'll be able to get collision time. And we need a little box around it as well, don't we? I don't want to use the lines, I actually want to have a block. So let's do it with these. I'm just after the size really on this one. Just like that. Well, it must be said, the other one's not animating. I could just make that the last frame. Seven sprites, because we don't have an unlimited set of sprites. Change this to really just be the end part. I'm obviously drawing everything else now, but it's going to just be the frame. At some point we'll get around to doing these things as well. Level, wasn't it? Draw that. Okay. So now what I'm going to do is when you click on the panel item, we'll highlight it. Because it scrolls, we can't really use the normal collision detection because they were scrolled off. There's no collision detection to GUI elements. We'll get that one day. But not at the moment. So we need to detect that they've been clicked. And I'm wondering if I want to bother actually having an object for them or if I should just draw it in a script. if it's kind of redundant, if you're not actually using it to store things or do anything like that. Let's see like that for the moment. It's one thing with throwing things in so quickly, you kind of lose track where everything is. Okay, so that's on there. Trying to remember where I did. Okay, so that's just kind of where we want to do it. To be left press. Just leave it open. Keep using it. Some six. And I'm going to end up drawing myself out, isn't it? Always comes like that. So create. Draw B. We'll just look through and draw it, because why not? See what's done with the wire. Probably not. The list goes wrong. Okay. Okay, wrong sprite, but almost. Then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 11. 11? That's 13 frames. Well, 13. Nothing. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Actually, you don't select these two. You just kind of click them up and down, and the selection stays on these. Still got one. I don't know. And then same for these. You don't select them. Or do you? That I'm not sure. I need to see if I can find. I know in later Lemmings we had this kind of animating pause thing, but. Can't remember for the first one what we had. Normally bings when you click them as well, don't they? Okay. So let's stop the selection on the easy one. Couple. Okay, so we can get selection there. There we go. Alright, so now what we want to do is kind of get numbers to put on these things for the different skill levels. Of course. it's in high res, isn't it? I'm feeling the bottom part of the panel was actually high res on the Amiga. They've changed screen mode on it. Yes. Oh, certainly did. So it's high res across the way. Not up and down the way, still the thing, but more pixels across the way. That's why you get these kind of thinner verticals when we're on that explains that. Yeah, okay. Right, so. So we've got timer, rotor, burner, walker, server, asher. We like the bees, don't we? Asher, miner, digger. That's the skills we get. So that's also why the numbers aren't quite right, because they've been shrunk down a little bit. Did I preserve? No, we've done. So my panel is slightly reduced res. That's not the way it looks in the actual game. They're higher res than that. But we can't change the res across the way, so they are slightly smaller. Also means my numbers that go inside the blocks will be slightly different as well. So enter. It's a little bit annoying. Skills. So now we need something ironically actually make characters that will fit inside this. So I need two digit types that are going to fit in here. Okay, so we're going to be a little bit thinner. And really, well, actually, in the original, they do actually touch the top and bottom, so that's not terrible. There's space on either side, I don't think we're going to manage that. Not quite making it look particularly bad. don't really want to do that. It would fit. Let's try it and see. So let's crop to this. What the hell is the other thing? That's weird. Okay. Challenge two. Okay. Three. Could take a dime because it can't touch the bottom, obviously. Kind of stretches two out a little bit, though. Which is actually quite nice. No, I think I'm gonna have to. That isn't the best thing to be sitting staring at either. I'm aware of that. I'm trying to hurry up. Yeah. I could do totally square ones, I suppose, which is different from the original. The original's a bit curvier, but might actually be better. In fact, you think it probably will be. Because then it becomes pretty straightforward. Much better. There you go. That will do. Okay, So now we just need to draw these. I had a score routine somewhere else. What did I do a score routine for before? What's the last games I did? Manic Miner. Might be Manic Miner. Let me just see if I can find that. I don't really want to write that wee bit again. As easy as it is, it's just boring and annoying. Scripts. Cross score. Oh, there we go. Let's just copy that. Right, so. Create. Oh, but not now. Score. Okay. So this was from the Manic Miner game I did last time. I don't really need to go up that high. Two digits. I kind of drew to the tile map. Again, don't need to do that this time. That's just how you draw it's fine. So that'll be panel numbers. Three wide, so four wide. Okay, probably fine. Cheat not writing that, but hey. And so where am I going to do that? Some library, isn't it? Nope, that is druggy. So like that, because I'm jumping around to it a lot. So we'll draw the panel, and we'll basically look through and draw the scores. We can just do it as well. Score. I haven't actually put in the values there. That's why it looks a bit weird. The score is it? It's the skill, but meh. Ba-da-da. Right, so that's where the score's drawn. So where is this? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. One down. So that'd be 9 times 16. 4, 7. And skills. Okay. What could possibly go wrong? That. And the challenge. Oh yeah, let's do it for them. We'll just do a different look. Let's see. Eight, so it's going to have a 16 upset as well. Hey, there you go. Just like I bought one. Although I should really add in release rates. I did planning so much. I don't know why there's two numbers in the plus and minus. So I'm just going to double check. Is there two numbers? It was a release rate. Is that the number left or something? Jeez, have we got a manual? Does anybody know what the two numbers were for the plus and minus? No idea what they signified. I don't think Russell's on tonight, unfortunately. No idea what those first two numbers are. Is there a manual somewhere? Oh, hang on. I have a copy. Hang on. The manual store in it, and it is. She actually says panel, there we go. Decrease flow, increase flow. Okay, well, I know that, but why is it two different numbers? Makes no sense whatsoever. Okay. That's bizarre. So the plus and minus is supposed to be the release rate. So if they're coming out tick, 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 you can increase it and go tick, 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 or you can decrease it and go tick, tick. Why it has two sets of numbers on it? I have no idea. And for some reason, I'm trying to find it out in a French magazine, but the English one didn't help, okay? It's of no help whatsoever. It's a stupid thing. Who did that? Okay. Numbers. Yes, that's the only way I can look thin, so shut up. Oh no, the plus and minus, the release rate, but it's got two numbers above it, and they're independent. I don't know how that's possible. Well, I didn't write that panel bit, so I'm going to blame Jobby Jones for that, because it's weird. It makes no sense at all. If Russell was around, they would pester him, but he's not online at the moment, I don't think. He might be. I think he is. I think his PC is just on. Right, I'm going to carry on as though it's just a stupid number again. So, stupid number. I have no idea what that means. It was just the number we used to tweak to see how fast they came out, but second number, the default release rate. But that wouldn't make any sense, because if you're changing it, it's the plus makes it go up. You look at videos of it, they kind of increment the first one up, unless it's the minimum it can go down to. But then you can click on the minus one and it goes down. Ah, stupid, whatever it is. Yeah, but you can reduce the minimum one. Does the first one never change? I can't find anybody clicking. It has to be said, you don't really click the minus very often. You don't tend to slow them down. You tend to just speed it up when you're ready. So, okay, we'll try that. Min and current. What the hey? It's not any stupider than the way it is. I'm still trying to find an actual video of it going down, but like I say, it usually just goes up. You kind of get things going and then you just pump the number up. But like you say, a minimum rate's maybe, that's a reasonable guess, so sort it. Yeah, that's what I'm going by. Let's just say that's the number. You can go up and down, but it doesn't go past that. Which is fine. It's still stupid, but it's fine. So now we're on to 10. So okay. That's nice. Okay. Right. That will do, I suppose. Okay. What I might do is just take away the floater skill from all these, so they just keep dying and then we can start testing skill assignment. And so the numbers go down. And we should also have on this. I get 10 hours to make as much as I can. I managed to make the whole game, great, but I don't think that's going to happen. The way I'm doing things as well, it's not the same way the code is, so I can't just insert levels. They just wouldn't play properly. But you could make more levels around this mechanic and it'd work fine. But the idea is just to get as much as I can get in 10 hours or less. So. So we're going to have a maximum of lemmings, so the trap door, and the alarm. Just knock that down. And reset the alarm. So we'll only release. It's getting not too bad. How long has this been going so far? So I'm currently about 4 hours in. So what you see is about 4 hours work. A lot of it's faffing around thoughts, you know, like anything you do, graphics, you sit and play with them and time just ticks by. So, but we're about 3 hours, 50 minutes in to be precise. Disable the floater. Blech. And then now we can see if we can pick and then assign. Which will be fine. Okay. The other thing I need to do is remember the one I've selected. So that I can then use that ID later. Oh, I've already got that, look at that. I'm going to change that ID. Okay, now when it's pressed, we can decide what it is that we would like to do, what skill is about to be applied, probably want to do that as an array in the object as well, so I can just assign easily without lots of ifs and buts. So obviously the crate have now got their CNUM thing. So I can use that in the lemming for its actual skills. I'm actually going to do this again because it'll be really fine. Enums are global, so you don't have to worry about it. Call that S skills. That's stupid. By the way, if you haven't noticed, in Studio you can call a mark and then you can do block typing. Just ever so handy. So select ID dot. Skills. Right. Slot picked. Sign said skill. Now, is that actually going to work? Because, it's silly actually, because things like builders and bashers are actually things they start immediately doing, not behaviors. It's only really the first two that are behaviours. Okay, we'll just do it the old-fashioned way. Because that's the floater and plumb. And the two that we're going to assign. So, if... insert those equals... on two, check the file. It's not fun. I should be checking skills first. Make sure it has climbers. Floater, so we'll come down there. Floater, okay, so same skill. Again, what's it going to do? What's wrong? Pop. Yeah, like that. Climbing. Not actually set. I did set that. That's interesting. Why would that have... this should be global without skills. Sorry. My bad. Let's go with skills. Because that changed. enums are also something we could refactor, actually. You know that. There we go. Unknown variable. What's unknown? Level unknown variable. Only selected. Oh, yeah, okay. So the problem is, let's just jump back again. That was supposed to be, that one's wrong. And that one's two. Okay. Only when we've got aligning does it care about that. Nothing. Look at that. Cool. Okay. Has the number actually gone down? Let's just keep assigning and see what happens when it gets to zero. And plumb it. Hey, run it. Cool. Okay. I can also do climbers, but I don't have that skill in yet. Really want water animating on these things. Second. See if I've got any backups of these things. Problem is, all my old stuff is just knee deep in folders. Takes forever to find stuff like that. This is video stuff. I have no idea. I'm going to have to rake through loads of folders to try and find loads of blue money stuff, loads of gore, hired guns, menace, walker. I don't see any. These are all kind of older ones. If you haven't seen it before, this is the old level editor we used to use. You kind of paint with these blocks, and that's the collision blocks you put around, just big rectangles over things. I'm just trying to see if I've got anything that's that's just the stuff I've got up on Flickr already. Need to try and find okay. So, start that again. Where are we? So, we can now assign things. Splish splash. I did love the way Lemmings' feet were perfectly on the ground, just stuck. Gary Timmons did the kind of Lemmings animations, just had a real feel for just nice solid animations. Okay. Let's see if we can increase the rate as well, I suppose. That's. Sure what the timer was. Is it just a frame count? Probably get that from walkthroughs and Lemmings is they immediately on first levels and stuff just rack the release rate out, so it's kind of hard to tell. Oh, look, run out of Lemmings. Do timer as well. Just a natural timer thing, isn't it? So we can probably do that. Probably use this as our initial timer. The first one comes out, it's not that important. And then that would go from this rate. Yeah. Okay, so let's do the version. So that's working out the slot. Must have been pressed. So it's the release rate. And that just goes up to 99. Actually, it's an inverse, isn't it? Because that's the speed you go. So 99 is the maximum speed. And that's like every couple of frames by the looks of things. So, yeah, okay. I don't know. I'm sure it's in the code somewhere. I'm not quite clicking that anyway. Please. See what that does. I don't know, just different things. It's kind of hard to. I'm usually using Studio Flow, I have to say. To see if I can figure out what this release rate is kind of based on, because I'm not overly sure. Not quite got the actual values right for it. Yeah, it's not quite right, is it? That seems a bit weird with that. Okay, oh, well, that's kind of working as well as it should. Whoops. Climber undefined. Oh, that's doing the same check, isn't it? So that's down here. The lemming might be dead, and I could, so whatever I clicked on or hovered over the last, so now I probably have to do the climber. So he just kind of, when he hits a wall, he just starts shimmying up the wall, picks at a time until he gets to the top and turns back into walker and then keeps going that direction. Sure, I'm going to get all the skills in. So. two, three, four, five, six, eight again. Liked our even numbers for animations, has to be said. Made cycling them real easy. You just increment the NAND it with 7, and it just kind of cycles around. You get rid of an if. And when you're on a 7 megahertz, 68,000 or whatever it is, all that adds up. I will have to rewrite this walker. I thought of several things that can go wrong with this. When you start getting little gaps and stuff, you have to actually count up the way and then count down the way. You can't just do a column because you could end up hitting spaces and thinking that's as far as you can go, but there'll be bits for us to go to. So you do have to split it and go up and down, which is the way the original one worked out, I think. So. Oh. Climb it in there yet? No, I didn't. So, what you get is you get a walker. If he's going to flip round, because it's too high, you're basically going to check if we have a climber. And set climber. So the climber is basically what? Check collision there. Needs to state his feet. Just do that. Let's check it up. Set it as a walker. Not otherwise move up, which would be just move up. Is that it? So let's just watch this guy. See what happens when he gets over here. He's kind of gliding as well. I'd need to watch some of the animations. I've got a feeling the animation again is based on the pixel position and why. Yeah. I do have to check above his head to make sure he's because if he hits something, then he just goes, okay, full turn round. Is his head. Let's just check the head. Two. Okay, so minus 8-ish. So look for an overhang of minus one. If we find that, and it's Steve Walker, but we also want to flip him around. Actually, it's probably not a walker, you probably want to set him to be a follower. Because you're climbing, so there's obviously nothing underneath you. Set to fall or flip them around. Let's try that. Ooh, got him just in time. I want fast forward. Okay, that's not quite right. Oh, that's not minus one, that's minus direction. I'm not quite sure where that is. It's going to the right. Pixel is up there. Oh, because it's not. Okay, try that. Okay, overhang. Hey, looks good. Should get an overhang there as well. Let's just see what he does with that, because it's quite okay. Pretty much what you'd expect. So there you go. Oh, he's going the other way, look at that. I think there's going to be much for you that way, guys. Might get, I don't know how to get through that. Let's go. Oh, we'll get stopped there. Okay. Okay. Kind of avoiding doing all the really annoying ones there, aren't they? Like builders and stuff. Okay. So I think check something. Yeah, he's got different yeah. Oh, drowners. I forgot about that. He's got drowning water, obviously, as well. Oh, I can't do that until I get until I get the water animated and I'm getting them as objects and stuff. Thinking is bomber is what I'm thinking. Then I could do the nuke because that's really what we want, isn't it? We want to see them all blow up. I'm going to defend a thing. I don't know. I've got a feeling the explosion was kind of pre-generated and just stored pixel offsets for all those explosions. So I'm not quite sure what I'm going to do about that. I could just throw pixels up in the air and look kind of similar. So to get the countdown on the head, I still want to use the draw score because that's got the little numbers. I normally use an underbar to say it's an argument. I don't really like using these, though. I quite like for them actually define stuff. We will get that in one day, you know that. Let's just make sure that's working. Still got that wrong. Oh. There we go. I don't know how many of you are actually using GameMaker, the beta, how you're finding it. That sliding animation's annoying. I wonder if it's kind of tempted to try using the Y coordinate again. I don't know about A. Oh, not doing that. Spot items. I don't know if it is, it just looks like it's sliding. Actually, it looks a bit better. Okay, I'm okay with that. I do actually see him flicking through the other way for them. So we'll let him fall, let him turn around, and then let him climb the other direction. See what he looks like. One in now. Oh. I'm gonna set one to go up that way. Looks good. Set one to go up the other way. Think it could do with being over a pixel, I have to say. The offset's not quite. Is it not quite right? I could just need to shift the offset, of course. Let's just have a look at this one. He's okay. He's, yeah, definitely in a pixel. Excuse me for showing you my balding head. So zero. Yeah, that's better. Okay. So let's. Oh no. Don't know if that's the exploder or. I don't know if that's the exploder graphic or if that's just from dying. Must be the exploding one. I actually think we had any. I thought we just kind of went pop. It's just a bit bland, isn't it? It just has his little head shake. I'm struggling to see. Ah, it says there. Yeah. So the top one is when he runs out of bricks building, I believe. This bit is when he's going to die. and gets nuked. Oh, for the greater good. I've had suggestions for doing a fill that fills everything of the same colour, which I think would be quite nice, I have to say. It's got me 16 frames. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 16. Of course it is. As I said, we like our powers of 2. With 16 and then probably 10, I would have thought. Yep. Do it. No. Pop. You know something, I could actually just put the big frame in as well. Because it's just a single black at the end. It was drawn independently before because it was so big. You didn't want to store all of the sprites like that, actually. Doesn't really kind of matter. Just set the offset for each sprite. I'm sitting watching a video where a guy nuked the last one. And I just want to see if it's a single frame or we need to duplicate. It just seems a bit faster. But to be honest. Yeah, cool it is. Yeah. That's probably fine. Okay. Bimmer. Bomber. Dun, 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 dun. Okay, so that's the origin is. There is a mask to go with this, actually. I'm going to close that. I need the mask. It's not there. Damn. There's like a little Easter egg shaped mask. It's got the Basher and Miner, I think they are. It doesn't have the bomber. Damn. Bums. Okay. The more I think about it, the more this hasn't got everything, has it? Okay, so let's change this one. It's kind of more elongated kind of shape. Just now. So it's 5 seconds the countdown was on the bomber. To get to zero, is it just faculty to one? Four, three, two, one. Then that triggers these. Okay. Could still do that as store x minus, actually x bar minus 10 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 comma. To just see what that looks like. It looks like nothing. Why are you not doing that? Draws the sprite. Just beside them. So, actually, 8's not quite enough. That's it should be white. And if we move black. Easy enough, but I can't move the other way. Okay. Color. Okay. What's the origin of this? Still black. No, you're still black. Digits for some stupid reason. Pixels and up another couple. Just now. Just take it down. Oh, I'm still setting it in the drawer. I still need that pop actually, just because it's. It's always ominous seeing the little counters over the head. Okay, so I've got counter, blah 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 blah. Oh, no, it's not 4 because it's 20. Oh, no, that's true. Okay, so it's 20. Blocker, stuff like that, you go into this head shaking state. If you're currently floating, you don't. Mm-hmm. actually do anything. This one. Destroy. Man, I could just basically blow a hole at this point. But you kind of want to gather them all together. So you can kind of set the target, look through them all, and just add or remove everything as you go. On the Amiga, PC in the old days, it would have just very much been process one, do a bit, do that, so all the other ones would be affected. So if one of them put a brick down on his frame, the next one would be hit by it, but actually this is going to delay it for a little bit. So like I said before, it's not exactly the way the original was written, but if you were doing new levels, it would matter, this thing would just work to the level you're doing it at. Or maybe if you're trying to play original levels, would you start having issues? So what I'm going to do is that be the level stuff. Oh, isn't that? Keep a list of all the add and removal things, and then in each list you have a little array of X, Y and shape to remove, X, Y, shape to add, and we'll just set a target and look through them all if it's not empty. Everything for time. So that's coming up in 5 hours. So halfway. Okay. Could do it as an add remove script, so that, you know, just say remove here and it would add in. But like I say, with the limited resources we've got, I don't want to do that. So what we'll do is just kind of align it. The subframe. Just add. The add one will be similar. So now what we can do is in the, let's do a draw end. Add, draw, invent. Let's only if there's anything to add and remove before we actually start playing on the actual surface. It's going to actually be this one, isn't it? And so this is the... Let's just stick a bit back there. So, first of all, we'll do the removals. Okay, I think one, two. Could do with the new number and then, I guess. Zero. One. That we can kind of build up a structure. But this will be fine. So around the removals, do our subtract mode. And then once you've done all the add removing, you get the collision back again. We also have to reset the list. Yeah. No. Alright, give me a little bit of time to think. Okay, it's actually gotten the element. Two, one. There she goes. Okay. 120. Actually, what I want to do there is set state format. No, I know that's not going to be quite right. Because our following thing is going to be wrong. So you'll change the animation halfway through the following, but that doesn't matter. Walker, Builder, Basher, saying you put those in. No, not Builder, Basher, Miner. Right. So if it's anything, these feet are on the ground, basically. Yeah. Then you can set the state to the kind of shrugging thing. Otherwise, you just get their name. For a moment, we'll just kill ourselves. But really, we want to print that blip thing over the top as well. Do for the moment. I think we'll do the bowler knight as a skill, which means assigning a skill. set the timer. Okay, let's see if we can set some bombers now. So to rescue a few. Rescue a few of these. Okay, looks like I'm not sure where we're assigning. Oh, it's the which slot is it? 2, 3, 4. Next one. Okay. So do that. Yep. got one that's too big. I've got my climb out of. It probably means my mask needs to be smoothed a bit more, because they used to be able to walk out the curve. Yeah, it's too deep. Let's see that, I'll move it down a bit. Still very satisfying. Oh! Yeah. So I will need to draw a big rectangle over there. And then when they fall off the level, they just get killed. Obviously, I need the. Pixels. What I'm going to do is a separate object, so it's just independent. When it finishes, it dies. How I'm going to get the actual animation for the explosion, I'm not so sure about it. Where is an exploder? Pixels very much go kind of up the way, and then they just fall off the screen, actually. Okay. So and for sprites. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 14, 15. Okay. These are quite small. What I'm going to do is cheat. use this one. Stick a pixel on it. And then we'll just draw that frame of the sprite in different colours. Numbers haven't got that high, so it's just, I don't want to have a huge image that I attach to. I could have a single pixel thing, but it seems a bit of a waste of a sprite. So, same with the mask, I could put it in the mask, but it's a single pixel. I don't want to use plots, because they will be dots, like you saw earlier, they're dots on a scaled screen. At least if it's an image, then it'll be a chunkier pixel. So, see 40 dots. I have no idea how many there are. Got this figure of 20 in my head, but I don't. That's right. Do is just have random velocities, basically. Random velocities, so actually cos and dxdy. They all start from a single point. I don't know. Let's say 4. Goes quite fast. 3. Range, so -2, 2. And Y should be always up. Four. That should also have a pixel in it. And then color. Save myself. The explosion. Yeah, that guy doesn't change the Y. Should get affected by gravity. I don't know. Just. Okay. Draw. Okay. this out. Numbers, comma, 0 to 9, 10, comma, plus. Maybe. Really. Plus. Return. 60. That's not 60. Basically, when they're all clicked off screen, we should be killing ourselves. Story. They're all off. Kill us. Okay, so. Lemmings. I just want to have a quick look at some stuff. This version of Studio has been running for about a week and a half now with different projects, so I'm curious as to how the memory's coping. I don't think it's our project, I think we've got a leak somewhere, but we shall see. Okay, so create the explosion, animation end, do the same. Let's see what it does. Who knows? Quite but out of mind. Why are they about there? And why are they so flat? Fix this and then we'll call it a night. I have a feeling gravity, but I don't think our random Y. Should be minus for a start. Going up the way. Just go up to here. Still zero. And it's still flat. Be what was going up to the top. It was a bit brutal. Okay, so might be too little now. Oh, see you. Should be a double kind of DD on it, just a bit too floaty. Strictly speaking, I probably shouldn't have gotten out of that one. Oh, Okay. It's kind of there, but see, it's a bit too floaty. Also spreads a bit much. Might be thought up. A bit faster. That's a bit better. That's more like it. That's all right, isn't it? Okay. Okay, 2.5. So that's 5.5 hours in. Call it night there. We've got not very much to get working tonight. So we've got the panel, we've got our release rate, which is wrong. We'll have to kind of go and study to see what the original Lemmings kind of speed was. So I've no idea. We've got a follow assigning skills. We've added our climber. Bomber, with explosion, so it's good. Okay, so I think maybe start tackling things like the builder next. See how much of him we can get in. I do have a last solution for the metal stuff that I could try. So we're going to get the holes in the metal. You also have to make sure when they do die, they don't go plummeting underneath the panel. Same with the dots, actually. The dots should be. I thought the dots were supposed to. Oh, okay. It's still kind of there. And I could do that in the draw, I suppose. Just off the bottom, don't bother doing it, and that'd be fine. We should stop there now. Yep, there you go. Keep pressing. Okay, that's enough for tonight. I'll start to upload all these onto YouTube, so there'll be a playlist with each game that I do, three or four videos of each of the ones. Like I say, we've got 4.5 hours left possible on this one. We'll see how far we get. Might get most of the skills done, but Basher and Miner are a bit tricky with their masks and stuff that they've got. They've all got to be synchronized as well. a little bit tricky. We get the builder in, blocker. I'm not sure how to do the blocker. I'm sure it just collisions with everything. I'm pretty sure we didn't do that before. It might have been actually setting a solid collision behind or something. Don't know. Okay, that'll do for tonight. Night night, peeps.